Welcome to TeamGuru's preview of new feature for our scale metrics. When you go to scale metric settings, now you will see there is one additional option, and it is to define scale metrics by job roles. And the main difference defining your scale metrics by list of skills or job roles, list of skills, you are able to choose one acceptable level for each skill in your skill matrix, and this level is going to be the same for all your employees in your skill matrix. With job roles, however, you are able to predefine your job roles in the system under skill matrix module and job roles. And once you do, you will see that for each position, you are able to select different skills that are required for that position. But even more, you are able to select different required levels for each skill separately per that job position. And let me just show you. And here I have a skill matrix that is defined by a list of skills on the left side. And on the right side, I am showing skill matrix that is defined by job roles. And here you see all your individual skills, employees. With the job roles, you will see the job positions and then the employees that they are included for the job position. And here I would like to show, let's say that you have an AD analysis skill, and now you are required 3 employees to be considered trained for that position, and they need to reach a sufficient level qualified. Once again, you have an option to choose only one acceptable level for that skill and for all those employees in the skill matrix. However, with job roles, you are able to tell that for that skill, you would like 2 people to be considered trained when they reach a level qualified, and 1 person to be considered trained if they reach the level trainer. And another main difference between these two is when you are actually adding new skills to already existing skill matrices. So let me show you. Now, let's say that you have several skill matrices through your company for each location, and they are all monitoring the same set of skills for their employees that they are specific for that location. And now you have decided that you would like to add another skill. If you are using a skill matrix that is based on list of skills, you would have to add that skill to each skill matrix individually. But with job roles, you would have to only add it into job role settings, and then it will be automatically reflected in all these skill matrices. And before we finish, I would like to also mention, you have an option to use our automatic color coding by fulfillment of the required level in your skill matrix, which means at first glance, you will be able to tell by color coding if the required level of knowledge for the position was reached. Green color indicates you reached the required level, red color you didn't, and blue you are above the required level. And to set it up or use this option, you have to go to skill matrix module, skill levels, and then you will have to choose that option in skill level settings and check this box for color code by fulfillment of the required level. And this should be it for a short preview of our new feature, but please don't hesitate to check our full video tutorial skill matrix. You can find it either on our support website, and I will also include the link in this video overview. And as always, if you have any questions or need any assistance, please don't hesitate to contact us at support@teamguru.com. We would be very happy to hear from you.